Korokoro, you may hear me why wine. I be saying you tanda giriba on top of the chairman television station, Wazobia Max TV. And this, now the first cocoa of the matter inside the month of November. November go be month when I go remember, when I no go cry, and the only news when I go to hear go be good news. On top of cocoa of the matter, what they do every Wednesday from 7 o'clock. When they discuss the cocoa when they inside the matter, those who understand Yoruba, when they say something na the cocoa, it means say na the fact, go. The thing when they affect you, when they affect me, when they inside the discussion. The idea na to carry people when sabi am come. These people go talk. When they talk finish, we go learn. And most importantly, when would they contribute to make our country better? We go do them in the way when we say, our country go be one way go make all of us inside them our belly sweet. And then we person when we say, if na book, it's a big book. In fact, as it is like this now, if he pass library, they must lock the door. Una know why? He don't read book, tire. Book go even the fearer. But he still continue, they read the book. If the person when we say, sense too much, it's not God, oh. In fact, he got the one we say, go waka now. They go into the carry fire extinguisher, they follow up. Because he head to the hut. When he begin to talk here about how we go take make Nigeria better, and where we go start from, and where we dey go, una go know say, and they talk, they re-talk. And they talk of the person when we say, he wear the jersey of the liberation movement for 2019 to say he will become president of Nigeria. And they talk of no other than Dr. Chris David. Oga Chris David, welcome to Cocoa of the Matter.
Thank you for having me. And I want to also thank Nigerians too for.
I know say you know they like talk too much. As you don't thank them now, make we go straight into our discussion. Our people went there for house. If you check your calendar, today make them 15 days, 2 weeks plus 1 day. Where we say something bad happened for the Lekki Toll Plaza. Not be just what happened for the Lekki Toll Plaza. Now this will happen before that time. Young Nigerians come out in their numbers to protest against police brutality and demand for the disbandment of SARS. They say Solomon Grundy not take quick action. Reach the way when governments take act, oh, because when people come out in their numbers and they raise their voice, they talk as one. You must take action or else you go see anyhow. But since that time, we don't see plenty things will not happen. Governments don't promise, say, they go reform. They don't adopt 5 for 5. They don't begin to take action. We don't even see video of people when they train. All those what? Say, now there will be new tactical units for the Nigeria Police Force. But people come and they ask, say, after all these things, where will they go from here? We move, but where will they move to? Are you moving to permanent site or we are moving into canal? Dr. Chris David, go break the thing down. And we will continue the matter. Before I even go back to that, make a talk here now because I won't set them up. We're going to invite them come here every month because this talk, not be talk where we say they finish. I don't go wait whether I go talk yes or no. As I don't talk, I know sure everybody don't hear. So if you come on, call they do anyhow, now let me say I don't already talk, I'm here. Dr. Chris David, once again, welcome to Cocoa of the Matter. I'm going to waste, I'm going to just go straight into our discussion. From all the things we happen inside Obodo, Nigeria, that time when we say young Nigerians come out, they protest, say end SARS, end bad governance, do this, do that, ensure that our lives are made better than the rest of them. I want to ask you first, before we come begin to enter where we go start from. When you see young people come out in their numbers, they stage this peaceful protest and exercise their right as to take this side of our constitution, how do you take feel? The thing make you feel bad, or you look and say, yes, it's about that time for these people to speak up and be heard?
Well, I would say, since we come back to, we come up from military rule, come this civilian rule or civilian government, or waiting with the call democracy. The only good thing when don't happen for this our country, now this protest. This protest when they say na answers.
This our democracy will not be 21 years.
Yes, the only good thing when don't happen, and be this protest.
Why you talk so?
Because they talk, say, if you not ask question, you not go get answer. Or you both talk, say, if there is no effective followership, there won't be effective leadership.
I bet not there, so Dr. Chris, he knows the book too much. Make I talk that in again, let people hear. If there is no effective
followership,
there will not be
effective leadership.
That what I mean, say, if people, when they follow you, not follow you well, then you, when you're there front, you are on your own.
Oh, yeah. Continue. So that is what happened. For the past 20-something years, 21 years, the youths or citizens of this nation, of this country, they not engage the system. They not engage the people when enter government.
So that one means
that's why
connection no day between those when they lead and those when they follow.
Yes. So this protest can't be say people can't wake up and say, we get position, we get role to play for this government. We need to ask them question. And they need to give us answer.
They must give us
answer. That was why you see, say when they say, okay, we don't answer, they say, no, talk to us.
Talk to us.
You understand? Answer this question. You understand? Now, as this thing don't happen, and you know the way our government can be, the way they can respond, can make things go haywire. Now, we don't take this position now. What do we need to do from here, from where we are, to how we go take get that better country when we talk?
Okay, Chris David, we go enter there one after the other. But it go good make I just establish something where you talk here now. Now say, one, in 21 years of uninterrupted civilian rule since the return for 1999, with this action where you see of young people, the thing is sweet you for belly because they don't begin to talk. And for democracy, everybody's supposed to talk.
Talk,
they in everybody right to talk. Number two, you don't also talk, say, even when government say we don't take action, the way when they take strong their mouth, meaning say, okay, now we will now they work for, and we must do this in that way, say the thing, they very, very good.
Yes.
Now when we don't come carry our nation and say, after all this thing, where do we go from here? Meaning say, after the reggae, what will be the next thing when we go play?
Yeah.
Now we'll go and start one after the other. After everything not happen now, where we deal like this now, what will be the way forward?
Okay, now, there are so many things we need to do. But first things first, we need to do about three things.
Okay, give us.
Now, the first one is called the value system.
The value system?
Yes.
What does value system mean?
The value system be like, say, okay, like this building now. You just see this up, Abi. But you know, under, there's foundation. You understand? Now, if the foundation not good, what will happen to the building?
The building no go, no go stand.
So if the foundation good, what will happen to the building?
The building go stand.
So the value system, I be saying, now the foundation upon which Nigeria is built.
Make I ask you, Nigeria need to, value system, how the thing is solid, how you take this?
It's not solid, that's why you see all these things, they happen. Everything when they see, say, this enters process, NSWAT,
Biafra, IPOB.
Yeah, all those things. Now, because of the foundation, we're not good. You understand? So there are things we need to correct for the foundation. You understand? And we both call and say the value system.
The value system.
Yeah, so the value system upon which Nigeria is built, we need to address them. You understand? Now, what is the question we ask ourselves now? What is the value Nigeria is currently built on?
Okay.
Would they hear you? Meaning say, what will be the current foundation
of Nigeria?
Of Nigeria. The current foundation of Nigeria is called inequality.
Inequality?
Yes.
That means it is no balance.
No balance. As people, they say life, no
life
balance.
No balance.
Yes. The foundation, no balance. That's why we have all these issues. So that protest, when the people, they go, they say, they tell Nigeria or the people when the government say, this foundation, they wrong. That's why these police people, instead of them to protect us, they kill us. Now, when we send someone to go represent us, instead of now to bring shared, commonwealth, now they keep them for themselves. You know? So, in terms of the reward system,
say person do good, they reward them for good. Do bad, they punish them for bad.
He not balanced.
Hey.
That's why you go see, say, professor, for school, they collect small money. Somebody when just go house, they collect big money. So all those things, now they cause problem. You understand? One section of the country, if you say the supreme, more than other, you know, all those things, now be the issue. So we need to correct that foundation. And for us to correct the foundation of this country, there are about seven things.
Okay.
That we need to put down. Those are the things we need to be discussing. You understand? So, my fellow youth, the things when we suppose they discuss now I won't talk so.
Okay.
So, number one, under the value system, is that we must demand for equality.
Equality?
Yes.
Meaning, say, the life must balance.
Level playing field for everybody. If I won't get employment for NNPC, I'm not supposed to know anybody.
It's supposed to be because of your qualification, your competence.
Yeah, everybody. You understand? Now, that equality is very important because that is the number one. Now, the number one stone when we're supposed to program it that. Because it simply means that everybody is created equally and that the life when God give you is supreme. Nobody, if you just carry gun or say anything, say, won't waste you. You understand? Now, the reason why we have government at all, the only reason why we have government at all, number one, is to say, you see that life when God give you? They put government there, say, it must protect that life and the property when you don't get. So, to protect life and property.
True.
Nine people, they talk for constitution. So, that one is under equality. You understand? Then, equality simply means that no race, no tribe, no religion is superior to the other. We are all equal.
Everybody now human beings.
Yes, everybody now human beings. So we must agree that everybody they equal in this country. We have equal opportunity to excel, equal opportunity to go anywhere and do whatever you need to do. Now, when we don't get equality, now that equality too, now in drive rule of law.
You understand? Say the law now, or gapata.
Yes.
Nobody there above the law.
Yes. So when we talk about justice and all, everything is under that equality. You understand? And if you read the formation of these prosperous nations, Singapore and all that, go and check their declaration of article of faith. You will see that equality. In fact, Singapore they say more equal society, just and more equal society. You understand? Now, the second one, when we supposedly talk about, is called meritocracy.
Meritocracy?
Yes. Meritocracy simply means that, yes, God created us equally. You understand? However, God also gave us different talents, different skills.
All of us, they're unique in our own way. We're special.
Special in our own way. Now, it is based on that uniqueness, our specialty and all that. Now we suppose assess opportunity. So you not go bring a person when Rick are Greek
to come do something where engineer they do.
They do.
It's not possible.
That's why you go discover. Say, we they do things and we know they get result. We they do things. We know they. At times I go just they laugh when government they say we they do empower. We they do this. We they do all those things. Yeah, just when they pour water on basket. You know, you go there struggle, say you want to do something, but you know they see the result.
They see the result.
Why? The foundation, no? Correct.
Hey.
And these principles, when I talk, so that meritocracy will not get out for Nigeria.
At all.
That's why you see, say, as soon as one person enter position for government, what do you go do? You go look for in village people.
Hey.
You go look for whether the person sabi, he not sabi, he not consign anybody.
Hey.
You go build. You know, cabal around them. So instead of them to now produce things, to do things when go affect
everybody,
things go work well and all that, then now their family interests, the tribal interests, you know, religious interests, sectional interests, now they go come the
focus on.
You understand? They say, oh, this position, now this section is supposed to come from. We don't want even know whether the person.
It's not the thing
or not. You understand?
Dr. Chris, if they pay me, sir, they won't stop you. Because I don't say you are on fire. But we go take small break. When we go this break, come back, we'll continue our discussion. But I won't beg, I make mistake from the beginning. I for tell them, say, they go carry biro and pencil. So that all this is when you they talk, we go they write them down. Our people went there for house. CEO, professors of political science. Public administration and local government and international relations and diplomacy. They don't talk rich what Dr. Chris don't talk here. I beg if you don't miss the first part, as we go this break, come back. In fact, the reason why I call the break now so that by rule and paper, you go carry out. And as Dr. Chris don't talk from the beginning, although he never talk, but I don't put inside the mouth. Say every month we will get this particular lecture because all of us need to learn meritocracy. Yeah, meritocracy. Not be, I wish you a Merry Christmas. Meritocracy. As we take this special, the things what we get, we go to use them to make our country better. When we go this break up, we'll continue our lecture. Today on Don't Pass Show, now lecture, Dr. Chris David, class is in session. When we go come back, we'll continue the discussion. Hey, meritocracy. Meritocracy. Welcome back to Coco of the Matter. My ogbonge visitor, Dr. Chris David, day side studio. Una go see say today, I home out. I see waiting past me. We all the learn. More continue the discussion. Now, before I cut you, not verse, so you been finished talk on meritocracy and how we take this special and how if we they use those things, now we go to see results. More just continue the discussion from there.
Okay, like I said, under value system, there are about seven things. But because of our time, let me just talk about the third one. The third one is called excellence.
Excellence.
Yes. Excellence simply means that even as you get that gift, when God they make you unique, you understand? They talk say iron sharpening iron. That is the more they use something, you know, you go they get better. So you are supposed to make sure that you improve yourself. That thing when God give you that talent, when give you, you know, you go improve on. So as you are improving it, the more you go they give to back to society. Now that excellence is very important. Do you know Dubai? That is the principle that is driving Dubai.
This same Dubai here.
Yes.
Will be like heaven.
Yes. That excellence. That excellence. Now, what think they drive Dubai be that? Because for Dubai, it is a principle that anything when they see for this world, when they good, they go bring them and make sure that they improve on them. You understand? They improve on that thing.
So, the so that they will not become better.
Yes, they will not be the first. In the whole world. Meanwhile, they see her from somewhere, but they go carry that thing. Before they go do it, they go make sure that excellence. They improve them.
Excellence.
It's the spirit of excellence. You know what I'm saying? The principle of excellence. And in our daily life, this thing they play. That's why they go give somebody job, contracts to do. You go do bad road.
Hey.
That one, there is no spirit, there is no principle of excellence.
Hey.
You understand? Now, let me give you now one example.
Okay.
You know this Bagada, when Bagada Road, when they Lagos?
Yes,
you can see the quality of the road.
Yes, so.
Now, excellence with that. Compare it with one when they go just do, rain go fall, everything go wash away.
Meanwhile, the billboard when they go put there say, we are walking, he better pass the road.
Yes. You understand? So, that is, now, that is the principle of excellence. We not get them for Nigeria. So, we need to bring all those things. Now, when we are discussing nationalities, instead of discussing of resource control, all those things, you know, that's why restructuring not the work. These are the things we are supposed to be discussing. You understand? This principle, you know, say is not pertaining to one person. It covers everybody.
Everybody.
So these are some of the things we need to discuss. There are other four. But let me go to the second thing when we youth are supposed to talk. The second thing is the independence of the national and state electoral commission.
Independence.
Yes.
That is those where they blow whistle for election.
Yes.
They must stay independent.
They must stay independent. Because as we get them now, they not stay independent.
Hey.
You understand? Now, it's very simple. Do election. After the election, what thing happened? Somebody they go thank the president and say, thank you for allowing this thing to be free and fair. Now, so it's supposed to be.
No, be so.
You understand? The thing supposed to be free. They supposed they independent. Now, how do you make them independent? The money when they supposed they give INEC. You're not supposed to come say they must go beg National Assembly or something for approval. No. Just the way they have statutory charges. That's how it's supposed to be. Now, even state, now state owned worse. State owned be say the governor of the state, you go down write the names of the people when go win chairmanship. And counselor. Meanwhile, that is the first point of contact when we youth suppose take enter government. But the way it there now, they're not there independent. They just there, the government will write the names of the people that wants to occupy that place. And that is how it should be. So as youth, we are supposed to now interrogate this system that, see, this institutions need to be independent. So the way we take protest that time, that is the same thing. And we don't need to wait to 2023. Because I hear people, they say, 2023. No, now we're supposed to start. Because the people, when they put for those local government, now then they use, they take rig those major elections. So we must make sure that there is election. Because in most states, no election. How can you say one the party when they power? Now you go win all the seats, win all the councilor seats. That's to tell you that there is no election. So as youth, We must start to interrogate. That is our starting point. Mm-hmm. Start interrogating that system. Let's hold the governors of our state accountable. We need this institution to be independent. You understand? Let there be elections. Let young people vie for those positions. Let there be vote. Let them count those votes. That is our starting position. Then the third thing is that we need to reform our electoral processes. This is 21st century, for God's sake. What stops us from electronic voting? Not be electronic voting where electronic now everybody they use.
Even for like that competition, Big Brother Nigeria.
Yeah, that's it. So what stops us from doing that? So there must be electronic voting. Even diaspora voting.
People when they live outside
when Nigeria, be Nigeria.
When be Nigerians. When be say that even they contribute to our economy.
Yes, if you go to American embassy, okay, the election, they don't start. But before now, the American citizen when they Nigeria, they go send their vote to that embassy. Then the embassy will now carry it as a seal and for envelope, carry it and send. It will be part of the election. So we also need to have diaspora voting in Nigeria. Then funding, because people go talk, say, we have just two political parties. The truth is that we just have two parties who have access to money. Government money.
It's
not supposed to be like that. So those two parties, when people they run, they think that they are not the only two parties. What it will make them like that now? Because they carry government money, public our own money, public money, they carry them. Take run their own election. So if you must play level playing field, that equality when I talk, simply means that all the political parties, if there is going to be funding for all of them, then provide that base level funding or minimum funding for all of them. So you have given them equal level playing field. Then they will be able to run for this election. You now have young guys who will be able to pick up those forms, you know, campaign effectively and vie for position. But if we not do all these things, your PVC not go count. Sorry to say, your people they say go and get your PVC. Your PVC won't count. And you know, again, if the electoral process is not reformed, if you even register for PVC, you not go receive them. You go register for PVC, you not go receive them. Then we also need to have continuous voters registration, just the way. You go to, if you want driver's license, you just walk into that place now and get your driver's license.
Or if your ATM expires.
Now, so it's supposed to be.
Nobody said they will get one season. People will go on a rush.
Not be like that. Let it be like, you know, any day you want it, just go and get your thing and keep it. You understand? So we must have all those
voters registration.
Then we must also establish electoral offense commission. You understand?
So that people will go and do badness inside election, yes. Will receive their punishment.
Yeah, not be say that day they will just bring talks. This before you know, we not know what thing happen. They not go fee arrest there. They nothing go happen.
And result will come happen.
They will just deliver result.
Dr. Chris David, I talk her from the beginning. Say talk plenty, and now I can't let you use your own mouth. Agree. Say when next we give you invitation to come continue from where you stop. My fellow people that watch Cocoa of the Matter on Wazobia Max TV, today our lecture don't stop on say we go get joint body when we say electoral offenses. Naim, they go to chook eye on top. Dr. Chris David, Nadia, in stop. When we come back again to discuss this matter of say, will they move this Nigeria go forward after everything what happened with NSAS protest? He go pick up from here. Dr. Chris David, do you promise to come when we invite you next time?
By the grace of God, I go there.
No, your voice no loud though. May they hear you well. May no be like
say. I go there.
Hear that? He don't talk. Say go there. Our people now he talk. He say go there. Thank you very much. Say you carry waka come. We also will continue this conversation. I very sure say plenty Nigerians they don't learn until we come back again next week. Cocoa of the matter. Remember, Nigeria and our country no go spoil. Make we join hands together to move this our country go the permanent side. Enough is enough for people when we say go they do us like this. Those when sabi. People like Dr. Chris David, when I don't hear the talk now, we'll continue to get this kind of conversation on top of Cocoa of the Matter. Una bye bye. Thank you so much. To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.